Bob, I think.
All right, we're all set.
Then we're gonna do.
That just was a crazy nightmare, okay.
Oh, you left that out.
Was this the last?
That is Lansing.
Oh, oh.
But if I may, I think we should put Alexander in there now.
Yes.
So it's like, I just wanted to mention, so maybe.
It's low jinx time. Going like this now. So just a reminder, we are observing some safety measures. We still have our little handy wipes for the microphone, so, you know, keep the microphones from making somebody dead.
Oh.
We are, our next in-person gathering is Halloween. And Elaine Marlowe will be hosting that. And there'll be prizes. I think we can have a pretty full show that night. Other than that, we only have one other announcement. We have a birthday tonight. Sandra Benet!
Hey!
Sandra.
Oh, my goodness.
So we're gonna do happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Oh no.
And many more.
Oh my goodness.
Still do that again in purpose.
Are you one? Are you two?
Are you three?
Oh, you never did that? We used to do that. Remember? Are you one?
We're gonna open up with a nature song. If anybody's noticing the battle in nature.
He's gonna play it. Woody's not playing. No. Okay.
Grapevines, their tightness strangles branches, and then the leaves expand into a blanket. The leaves from trees and vines vie for sun rays from the sky. The battle is between the trees and the grapevines. And we have other solar panels coming. It's kind of weird.
Special
announcement to bring up our great piano player, Woody Regan. And we have a good lineup tonight. We're going to begin with one of our songwriting lambs, and that's a major part of the songwriting. The lamb's history is built by many songwriters who founded ASCAP, by the way. Dr. Sue. She is Dr. Sue. And coming up first to introduce us to a song we may already know. Let's see.
I am so happy to be here. I am going to start with the song that I did not write. I'm going to sing the song straight, and then I'll do my little parody, and you probably know it. So if you're ready, Woody, I am too.
Everything you've got. Oh, it don't mean swing a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do-wah, 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 do-wah.
For Woody and for Alexandra. Are you playing together for the first time? Mate, we are next bringing up, the next person we're bringing up to the stage, well, in a few moments we'll be introducing Alexandra, but don't tell her because she's in the middle of a conversation.
Where is she?
So keep it very quiet. We'll have to play Alexandra.
Here I come. Right back.
So, ladies and gentlemen, Alexandra,
here
she is.
Oh, come.
I'll keep this brief little preamble. First of all, as you probably can tell from all of this, I'm a millennial. I'm pretty committed to that milieu, unfortunately. We believe our credo as a generation is it didn't happen if you didn't record it. So I'd like to keep my personal phone on me to make sure I don't fudge the lyrics. I know that's not proper form, but if anyone would be amenable to taking a tape of this so I can show my friends later that I did this, that would be appreciated.
I'll do it.
Certainly.
I'm just telling you right now
it might not
that sending videos doesn't always work.
Well, you know, if we lose it, then that was fate.
Lost a heavy file.
Time.
But I'll always try.
All right. Okay. Thank you for humoring me.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a good light, too.
Oh. Feet are aching, and your back is pretty tired. And we drunk a couple bottles, babe, and set our grief aside. The papers say it's doomsday, the button has been pressed. Oh, we gotta nuke each other up, boys, till old Satan stands impressed. Here it is, our final night alive, and as the earth runs to the ground, oh boy, it's you that I lie with as the atom locks in. Oh, it's you I watch TV with. Going out in style, babe, and everything's on sale. Creep up on extinction, pull your arms right in. While we've been saying goodnight, love, while my organs pack it in. And here it is, our final night alive, and as the earth runs to the ground. Oh boy!
talking about the nuclear apocalypse, you know, keep it light here. Thank you, everyone.
Show us now. The song itself is from where?
So this is a song that's actually weirdly very contemporary. It blew up on TikTok with the kids, the Zoomers. But it's by Matt Maltese. But I saw a comment on YouTube where someone said, I wish Frank Sinatra was around to sing this. And I was like, that's a thought. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Yes. A different generation.
That was terrific. Thank you so much. You were great. Terrific.
Well, Donna is.
And you got the lyrics from
When the World Caves In. So, Donna, what is your choice for your song tonight?
Yes.
Here she is.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Is there a glove sometimes we see?
Yeah, I don't have.
Oh, do you
want to
do this?
No, I'm just helping you. We're living in umbilical cord.
Bob Greenberg, ladies and gentlemen.
I represent IATSE.
Thank you very much, Mr. Greenberg. You always come
hopefully
through.
Hopefully they don't go on strike.
Thank you very much.
All right, so you have plenty of cord.
Get rid of that, that part.
You don't need this part?
I don't want that
part. Okay, I will not stand for this.
I want it.
All right?
And the champagne.
Who
that's
needs
one
it?
Okay.
The stage is yours.
Oh, thank you so much. Well, welcome to the Lambs, all you lovely Lambs and your guests. My name is Donna Diva Darling, a.k.a. Miss Donna Diva, a.k.a. Miss Donna, a.k.a. Donna. You can take your pick. Now, this next tune that I'd like to do this evening was written by, well, he wasn't really famous, but he worked for a very famous man. His name is Helmy Kressel, and he was the musical director, arranger, producer, everything, transcriber, musical secretary for the late, great Irving Berlin.
Oh.
And what makes it so interesting is, and what I think is very interesting, is that he wrote this song in the early 30s, and he was Mr. Berlin's musical secretary for 23 years, and I'm so glad he could get away from Mr. Berlin long enough to write this next tune. Okay, maestro, please. I recall the night we spent together, laughing and dancing where life was just a song. I recall the night we parted forever, leaving a wish in my heart that lingers on to spend one night with you. Pressing on my of your soul. That's my desire.
We have maybe a new standard coming up. I believe Dr. Sue has been inspired by some of the old standards. And so we bring her up again. Welcome to the stage, and Donna, thank you for seeing that. And your bowl is here. All right, we're probably going to return our
poll. Is that politically correct, poll?
Oh, yes, I'm learning political correctness. I have touched upon gender on my recent musical, and I learned quite a bit.
Now, don't be a stick.
Right.
Okay.
I'm over here. Yeah. All right. So,
great.
Dr. Sue.
How do you do?
Oh, boy.
Oh, well, it's a pleasure to be here.
Well, welcome Lance, back.
And we'll try to get the microphone a little better.
I actually, I'm not a crew person, but I play one on TV. Yeah, how's that?
This sounds not quite right. We should tilt it like this. How's that? Is that a good place for it?
Sounds good to me.
Okay, good. So I'm going to sing my original song from my musical, Switch the Musical. And it's called Can a Dream Come True? Gazing at me tenderly, or are you a fantasy? Can a dream come true? I was used to cloudy skies, thought the land of Oz was. Are there rainbows in your eyes? Can a dream come true? Is that sweet shiver up my spine a magic draft? Why is this chill, or is this thrill enchanted craft? it. Oh, I can't tell what is a spell and what is real, but I'm loving every moment of this mystery I feel. When you hold me in your arms, I'm enchanted by your charms. Hearing bells, but not alarms. Can a dream? Can a dream come true?
Dr. Sue and her new standard, Can a Dream Come True, which is a witch story. Is it good for Halloween? I think so. Switching spell.
Witch story.
Switch.
Oh, switch.
Switch for those of us who are changing genders.
Oh.
No, I identify. I'm next bringing up, a man who's actually at the piano. His name is Woody Regan, and he is going to share one of his performances. We're very happy to
have
that is included in the show. Woody Regan.
We love Woody.
Thank you, Peter. Oh, it's on, isn't it? Well,
it's a song.
This song dates from 1973, which you may find hard to believe. White folks hate the black folks, and the black folks hate the white folks. To hate all but the right folks is an old established rule. But during National Brotherhood Week, National Brotherhood Week, AOC and Donald Trump are dancing cheek to cheek. It's fun to eulogize the people you despise, as long as you don't let them in your school. The poor folks hate the rich folks, and the rich folks hate the poor folks. My folks hate all of your folks. It's American as apple pie. But during National Brotherhood Week, National Brotherhood Week, New Yorkers love the Puerto Ricans, cause it's very chic. Step up and shake the hand of someone you can't stand. You can tolerate him if you try. Protestants hate the Catholics, and the Catholics hate the Protestants. The Hindus hate the Muslims, and everybody hates the Jews. But during National Brotherhood Week, National Brotherhood Week, National, let's all smile at one anotherhood week. Be nice to people who are inferior to you. It's only for a week, so have no fear. Be grateful that it doesn't last all year.
That's not what I was going to say. But Zora, every week is National Brotherhood Week. We're going to celebrate it every week. That was really touching. John Lehrer touching us all.
I'm Larry.
Is he a New Yorker at all, or was he just in Boston? You know, being that he poisoned pigeons in the park, I always
think of Boston Parks Department put in a program to poison pigeons.
Oh, it's terrible.
For real.
Oh, wait, so did you hear that? Woody was just explaining that that was a problem in Boston. They were poisoning pigeons in the park. Wow.
The Boston City government.
The city government.
Wow.
And what are we doing? Well, we have some interesting things going on with bikes and people, different types of motor vehicles that are showing up on the sidewalk more and more. We want to be more careful about that. Maybe enforcing. Okay, so, but here we are in the present day. Why am I holding this? Because, well, in order to understand that the man who I just saw in the movies, he was in Tango Shalom.
Oh, my goodness.
I actually, you know, I'm there in the movie. I said, what the hell? Is it, can you believe this? This comedian that I've seen all these years and impressions, but I've mostly seen him live. You know, some screenings, maybe. But there he is on the screen. It's Bob Greenberg. And what coincidence, because here he is right now.
Hey.
Wow.
Wow.
All right. It's Bob
full
Greenberg.
Of hamburger. Thank you very much. Just got that. Yes, I'm a lamb full of hamburger. That's right.
Lamb burger, I guess.
Oh, my goodness. So, yeah, I usually sing around Hanukkah time, Hanukkah and Santa Monica with Woody. That's an, also a Tom Lehrer song. Not as loving as the one he sang. But you know, I just, I'm really here for a PSA, right? Because Peter asked me because I have this play called The Stella. If you need a card, I'll pass one out if you like. And the Stella, people have been asking me, what is the title? It's not the Marlon Brando Stella. It's not that. It's not Stella Stevens, although I do like Stella Stevens, you know. It refers to Stella Liebeck. She's the 79-year-old woman who spilled a hot cup of McDonald's coffee on her lap. And the Stella, I play a personal injury lawyer, which you know means I'm a bastard. You know that, right? Okay. And, pardon me, young lady. There's a lot of words I cannot repeat that I say in this show.
She's all right.
It's very David Mamet, let's put it that way. And there's a case, a ridiculous case that the story revolves around. And the goal of every personal injury lawyer is to win the Stella, which is the Stella Liebeck win against McDonald's. So that's the title of it. So, and it's a very funny show. Thank you to the Lambs. We got to rehearse here. That's the wonderful thing about the Lambs, that you can do that here. It's a nice thing. And we have shows next Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. And over the summer, I did a show called Bulls. Anybody watch Bull? You watch Bull?
Yeah.
Well, I did 2 days' work on it. They wanted Pontel's, the hamburger. It's very good. I'm moving it from here to there. And I play juror number 9. I wear a mask. I say no lines, but I do a lot of acting with the eyes. So watch the eyes. I do the stink eye, the cross eye, the rolly eye. I do it everything. And it was so funny because I saw a teaser for it last night at the end of Bull. So I'll be playing a lawyer on stage, and the next night I'll be a juror on television. So if you happen to watch Bull, look for me. You can't miss me. The role was a burly juror, so I guess I am burly. I thought I was fat, but no, I'm burly, I guess. Maybe that's code. I don't know. So. Another question about the play, it's written by Greg Greenberg, and people ask me, is it a relative? And I go, no. There's at least 2 Jews in New York named Greenberg, right? You think? There's got to be at least 2 Jews named Greenberg in New York, I think, at least. So, no relation. And the other question, you mentioned Tango Shalom, somebody asked me about the film. It is playing at different theaters. It will be streaming at the end of October. I believe it's October 29th. So you can stream it to MOD, VOD, IUD, LSD, COD, whatever, you'll be able to see it. So, Zygesund, I'm going to finish my hamburger, so let's go over here. And see the Stella if you can. I do have flyers, like I said. I'll pass them out. And God bless you.
God bless you.
Good luck.
The world of personal injury. Okay. My mama done told me. I need help. In the millennial way. My mama done told me. Train. lonesome whistle blowing across the trestle. Hooey, my mama done told me. A hooey da hooey of clickety clacks echoing back the blues in the night. The evening breeze will start the trees to cry it, and the moon will hide its light when you get the blues in the night. Take my word, the mockingbird will sing a saddest song, kind of song. Standards and everyone, the words are so great. And I guess the one about that with the clickety clack is actually echoing back the blues in the night. It's just beautiful. Because Johnny Mercer, maybe this one particular name we'll see often enough. So I don't know, Mark, you have something to what could possibly top Johnny Mercer's work in blues in the night? Well, ladies and gentlemen, our shepherd, Mark Banner.
Yes. Woo! There he goes.
No.
He used to work in a steam bath, didn't you?
This is a song I haven't done for 2 years because I only do it once a year and we haven't had an October back in life. This is something Johnny Mercer wrote after he died.
Wow. Talk
about a good songwriter.
Yes, really amazing.
Musicaling is off.
To see October.
share the happy years. I turn my head away to hide those helpless tears. Oh, how I hate to see should be over it now, I know. It doesn't matter much how old I grow. I hate to see
So that was it. October will go with Halloween with Elaine Marlowe. So get your costumes ready. Zora, she's been watching Little Shop of Horrors, which is interesting, you know, because his sequel is called The Little Mermaid. He's really quite a talented lyricist. Howard Ashman saved musical theater in, you know, through Disney. So next up is Halloween with Elaine Marlowe. And now we we want to also acknowledge our accompanist throughout. It's Woody Regan at the piano. Thank you, Woody. Beautiful work. And for the Tom Lehrer, bit of good advice for us on that one special week. I'm not sure when that week is. So everyone joins in hands. We haven't done this for a while. Maybe we have a couple of weeks ago. But I mean, welcome back, everyone.